Hello, we are here today to celebrate, if that's the word, the World Paperless Day. Now, it's fashionable to say go paperless. What does it really mean? In the age of internet and IT, we hear all sorts of things about going paperless, but it's not an easy task, especially for those who've been sitting on reams and reams and almirahs full of paper for decades and in some cases even centuries. How do we take it to the next level? That thing is called document management. Now, I just walked into the office of Eisenhower based in Noida, which is precisely in this field. And what I found here is a book that says it's XBRL for dummies. But I said, how about doing the document management for dummies? Which is why I'm going to talk today to the co-founders of Eisenhower, which is a nice little startup. We have Vipul Swaroop and Vinay Singh, the co-founders of Eisenhower. Apart from wearing two nice blue shirts, what else do you do together in matching shades?
So Vipul and I started this company around 2 years ago with the idea to help corporates, especially SMEs and small companies, go paperless. That is the vision we have, but we are somewhere in between where we're helping companies be more efficient and use less paper as much as they can. So we help them in the whole process of going digital, from scanning documents that they have in their warehouses, huge reams of papers that they have, as I mentioned, put them on an online storage or on the server using the Eisenhower software, and if required, store these documents in a physical warehouse at an offsite location, which will be more efficient from a cost perspective and also retrieval perspective if required.
I do want to ask you some hypothetical questions, you know. It's okay today, you have companies which are called born on the cloud. That means you start from day one on the cloud, therefore everything is archived on the cloud, or they say internet, you have Google Docs and stuff like this. But suppose I am a 100-year-old company, I'm thinking of, let's take a very extreme example. We have Motilal Banarsidas, one Indological publishers sitting in Banaras. They have everything from Vedic age books to Upanishads and others. Suppose they have an ancient library in front of them. Do you think it's possible to even convert that into a paperless office? Tell me.
I think Vipul would be better positioned to answer.
I think definitely possible. We've done something very similar for one of our customers. Mm-hmm. They're a corporate, they're more than 100 years old. Mm-hmm. So they have documents which are dating back to 1890. Mm-hmm. Documents which Mahatma Gandhi exchanged with their founder, mm-hmm. or Lal Bahadur Shastri exchanged with their founder. So over the past century and a bit, so they had all these really old documents which we've scanned, and we've scanned them using specialty scanners so as to make sure that the entire document is captured, being in different sizes and being in different qualities. So we've had people handling them very carefully. There are some documents which are really old, which are falling apart, so they have to be handled very carefully. But they've all been scanned and they've all been stored in the Eisenhower document management system. Mm-hmm. And now they're easily searchable. We've run optical character recognition on these documents, so the English text and the Hindi text is now full text searchable, even in the older documents.
That is very interesting. So at the core of this is two elements. One is optical character recognition, so that even old handwritten kind of articles, almost, if not many of them can actually, they become as good as web pages. That is a very interesting point. The other thing I want to know is, what is so special about searching documents of the kind that you are talking about? How different is it from a simple Google search? Is there some indexing you do? Can you tell us more about this?
Yeah. So we define document types. Mm-hmm. So for example, a company is uploading invoices, mm-hmm. or a company is uploading employees' Aadhaar cards. Mm-hmm. So we would define a document type called an invoice or an Aadhaar card. And then on that document type, certain properties are defined. So the Aadhaar number, employee name, mm-hmm. or invoice number, who is the invoice from, invoice date. Mm-hmm. and when these documents are being uploaded,
mm-hmm.
the user is forced to capture this data
mm-hmm.
for each document.
Mm-hmm.
So they're forced to key in the invoice number, they're forced to key in the employee name and so on.
Mm-hmm.
Now what happens is later on when they go to look for a certain invoice,
mm-hmm.
so say 5 years from today, you want to find an invoice which you may have received in the month of October 2016. Then you'll be able to do an advanced search and you'll be able to filter your results by year, by month,
yeah,
by supplier.
Keying in has to be done by your client. You're not doing it yourself. Is there a...
So we would offer the customer both options. When we would scan a document, we would also offer to create the metadata
mm-hmm.
for the archival documents. But it will be healthy for them to, for the ongoing documents to create the metadata of their own. Having said that, what Vipul said, the document is anyway searchable because we are using an optical character recognition, but we are adding another layer of searchability by adding.
In other words, instead of simple being a random keyword search, you are adding an element of systematic indexation so that it's like instead of piling up a whole bunch of books in a godown, you're creating shelves. So for the dummy, the important thing is that you're creating shelves in the cloud.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that brings me to the next question. Where does this, all this rest? Is there a website? Is it the company website? Is it your website? Where does all these documents that get evaporated from physical existence go into?
Okay, I'll answer that question in two ways. The first is electronically and then physically. So electronically, we provide the customer an option of whether he would like to store it on the cloud, which we always recommend because of various features and functionality that cloud would be able to offer, and the security is taken care by the large cloud providers.
Mm-hmm.
So we could offer it on a public cloud. We work with some of the largest cloud providers, or we could offer it to be on the company's server itself if they have an efficient and robust system where they would be responsible for security and the backup and others. We could also offer a hybrid model where we could have the data on the cloud or on the server and back it up, vice versa. So you could store the documents on your own server, but have a backup in the cloud just in case, God forbid, something happens to your server.
Mm-hmm.
So that is for the electronic side of the storage. For the physical side of storage, we could offer to index and sort these documents and put it on the premise itself so they're searchable, or we could store it in one of our warehouses, in a physical records management warehouse, which is far away from the commercial area, then the price is just more palatable than putting your documents, say, in an office in one place where you're
building. The interesting thing is that some companies may be even able to save on real estate costs from this.
Yeah.
So is it possible to say that what you save on the real estate can be easily used to go paperless? That means you're actually not spending more?
I think more than that. So you will save on real estate, but you'll also save on efficiency because, say, if I have 100-year-old documents in my warehouse, the chances that I would send a peon to find the particular document would probably take a couple of days. So look at the man hours you would be losing to retrieve that single document. If it is in a professionally organized physical records management warehouse, they exactly know which rack, which box the document in. You tell them this file you're looking for because it will be barcoded and indexed. They'll retrieve it and send it to you the next morning.
But if you're going paperless, why do we need to keep these documents? Is it for legal purposes or is there something more?
Yes, so by law, certain kinds of documents are required to be kept in the physical original form for a certain number of years. For example, accounting documents, the law varies between 7 and 10 years. Similarly for other kinds of documents, plus some companies have their own policies as well. So employee documents, for example, they might want to keep for a while to prevent litigation or to be able to draw upon in case of any litigation. Then things like lease agreements or your purchase land purchase agreements, those kind of things. Typically, the courts require physical originals.
Mm-hmm.
So there are some of these legal documents which are needed to be kept in the physical original form, but the vast majority of day-to-day paper can be kept in digital form. For example, invoices.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to keep them in physical form.
So the essence of it is that what a good document management solution or service company like yours offers is a double combo of convenience and comfort of paperless use with the assurance of paper where required, with various kinds of hybrid model, be it in storage or in access. right?
Correct.
But that still brings me to a very important question, which is, what does this mean in terms of software? Is this your own product, or what have you done to, you know, I can imagine scanning and storing, but how does this whole thing get managed in the back end? What is the software, or is there something like ERP?
Sure. So we built a document management software, branded IsoBot, which we host in the cloud. So what that does is it allows a user to upload documents, to store these documents as long as they need them. They become searchable. They can apply various security and access control rules on these documents. They can share documents with other people as part of workflows. So there's all kinds of value-added features there. So it's more than simply buying cloud storage space and dumping documents there. There's a lot of intelligent sort of document management, document sharing, document security features built on top of that.
That's interesting. This is very, very interesting because we've been hearing about trees being cut and what are being used for paperless offices, and but it's easier said than done. There's a lot of plumbing required to for offices to actually go paperless. You know, it's one thing to say avoid printing this on a printer, but another thing to actually migrate on a large scale from a culture of paper, because I believe even as we speak, in spite of the arrival of the internet, trees are being cut. But that reminds me, how did the two of you stumble onto this space? You have any background in document management yourself, or before you founded this company, IsoBot?
So before we can answer the question, you spoke of with paperless. IsoBot initially gives you options to make this a collaboration tool also. You could actually work simultaneously in a single document. You could use it as a file sharing mechanism also. So it helps you. I mean, going paperless 100% is fairly utopian as of today because a lot of legal requirements are there. But it is a huge leap towards possibly going as minimum paper as possible, and I'll let people answer the question.
Yeah, basically it's as paperless as you want it to be, yeah, based on
correct
comfort level. So it's like a pizza model. You
correct
can take a basic paperless model and add toppings of various degrees of existing paper.
So to answer the question about how we got into this business, so I used to work for IBM in Australia,
mm-hmm,
where I used to work on document management software.
Mm-hmm.
So I was part of a team which used to implement document management software for third-party customers. And there I worked with some of the industry-leading document management systems and got a good understanding for how different softwares work, what their features are, how they compare with each other, and what kind of usage scenarios do customers use them in. Post that, I did an MBA, and after that, I was doing some research on various market opportunities in India and saw that this is a major opportunity because there are a large number of medium-sized businesses, and every one of them is struggling with a massive amount of paper, and they all need to somehow reduce the amount of paper, to reduce the overhead, to reduce the cost. And so given my background in this, I decided to explore this opportunity further. Then Vinay and I got together and we started off this company about a year and a half back.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been going upwards ever since.
Vinay, how do you know Vipul and how did you get to?
So Vipul and I were introduced to some common friends. When I was at Thomson Reuters, we had a management intern who was doing his rotation. So he happens to be family friends with Vipul. And that's how we got introduced. And when I was exploring options of becoming an entrepreneur, Vipul and I discussed various scenarios, and we actually looked at other things we wanted to do in the digital and technology space. We did market sizing and numbers, and what we found was something like a document management solution could be sold across industries, whereas if you did a legal database, it was a very, very narrow vertical that we go to, or a tax database or a tax solution. Whereas the applicability of a document management system could be right from a shop, which generates a lot of paper, to a medium-sized enterprise, to a very, very large company which has thousands of employees. So we thought this would give us huge portion to grow in
a huge addressable market. That's pretty interesting. The name of your company is Eisenbohr, which is, I believe, your German word for iron.
Okay.
I found it very, very interesting because, you know, when we use the word file name, the word file comes from the iron filing that used to be put on paper. So we still use the word file name, although we've stopped using iron files because we're creating Word documents and presentations and stuff like that. So it's interesting that things have come a full circle to a different kind of iron. That, I suppose, is good enough. I hope everyone got an idea of document management for dummies. Here's wishing you all a very happy World Paperless Day.